All right, so we're gonna take a left back on this road to the exit up front. I'll let you start yours up first. I wanna hear it.
Ooh, smooth.
Oh, nice. We got a little Miata. Whoops, slip neutral. I do that sometimes in this bike. Miatas are cool if you don't like surviving accidents. Let's go. I can hear my bike in your microphone. It feels good to be able to ride the Magna again, though. I haven't really ridden that much. As soon as I say that, I hit a bump with the fucking hardtail. Shoves my spine up my ass. I got the pretty Miss Laura. She's with me behind me on her Gixxer. Gross. Just kidding. I like her bike a lot. Boom. Does it sound like a gunshot? I've got a sticky throttle, which means I've got cruise control. Hopefully I don't need my brakes since they suck. We're on our way to our bike night meetup, the third Wednesday of every month. Hopefully there'll be some dickheadery. It's nice and warm, so people should be coming out no problem. I think the only thing that people run into is that a lot of people don't get off of work till 5 or 6, so they have trouble showing up at 5. We're actually showing up a good bit early, just because I'm tired of showing up late to my own bike event. I can't tell you how many times that I show up late. It'll be like 5:30, I'll be pulling in, everyone's like, "Oh, you're late, dickhead," and I'm like, it's because of who I am as a person. You can ask Laura, I've never been on time for anything. All right. Ah, that damn clutch. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Fuck yeah, Bubs. Let me get up next to this pretty lady real quick. Woo-wee! Look at that thing right there. Nice. How'd you like the power? Yeah, it feels good. You'd probably squeeze another 10 or 15 horsepower out of it with an exhaust and tune. Come on. I want to see it. Things pretty damn quick. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how happy are you with your purchase right now? A 12? That wasn't on the list. I shoot fire on him. Boom. Bang. Laura says she likes it better than the CBR and the R6. And look, we got a little Honda Shadow up here next to us. You used to have one of those. Yours had the exterior. I think that's like a 750 maybe, that has the softtail style where the suspension is built inside the seat. Honda Gixxer. Well, Suzuki. That guy looks either really tall for that bike or his handlebars are set up awkwardly. Whoa, what the fuck? That guy fucking just slammed on brakes for no reason. I wasn't ready for him to just slam on brakes like that. Wouldn't it be funny if he was showing up to the meet? That'd be kind of cool. Then I could talk shit to him in his face. Hey, get a brighter blinker, but brake light, you little bitch. I have no room to be talking. This bike is literally the most barely acceptable roadworthy bike in the world. It's got no mirrors, no blinkers. It's got a single brake light that's there in the fucking back right that's dim. It's got a straight pipe exhaust. It runs, sometimes. The clutch slips. The front brakes don't work half the time. And when they do work, it's either soft or fucking hard. It's got two modes, full lock or sloppy seconds. The rear brakes don't work. That's a joke. Hey. You're pretty. Yeah. It's hard to believe this bike has over 50,000 miles, though. I mean, it looks like it, but it needs to be redone. A full rebuild would probably benefit this bike pretty darn good. I like the handlebars, but I think I'm gonna go back to my drag bars. It's crazy that this thing is a V4. It's got twice as many cylinders as a Harley that I rode the other day, and it vibrates maybe a tenth as much. God, it feels good to just relax and cruise, though. It's such a nice day. Don't make fun of his rolled-up jeans. I've got rolled-up jeans. It's because I'm short, though. I need to get the back brakes working again. Sure would be nice on this thing. Hey, it looks like we're all together in a group, even though we have no idea who this guy is. You want to name him like a pet? All right. I think Sheldon. I'm feeling a Sheldon. A Tyler? I have to see his face. Tylers are very specific in their faces. Yeah, every Tyler I've known has been pretty skinny. Broom. Wait, look at me. Down. A little bit, like, look down. A little bit more. Up, up, up. No, look a little up. Yeah, there you go. I can see myself in your reflexive visor. Hopefully he didn't see me going very fast. I don't know what the road is on this. I don't know what the speed is on this road, but I'm pretty sure I was doing over it at one point or another. You're gonna have to work us my backwards lights or my backup mirror, because I don't have any mirrors. So if I get pulled over, I won't know about it. Oh, it's 55. Fuck you. Let's go. Me, you, and Tyler. I'm just making sure there wasn't anybody behind us. And Lord said, let that be a thunder. And lightning! Are you comfortable on that bike? Is it like uncomfortable at all for you? Oh, G-Wagon, aka the Trap House Mobile. Every house that I've ever seen that sells hella drugs has got one of those parked in front of it. I just love the way this bike feels to ride. I feel so fucking badass. I think Tyler also approves. He rolled by nodding his head. God, I want to ask this guy his name. I swear to God, if it's Tyler, I'm going to lose my shit. Lucky draw tattoo, huh? How lucky can it be? Damn, chica. You're looking fine, I say. Nice. Oh, dude, a 300 GX? What? Those things are cool. I want to play some GTA all of a sudden. I forgot to charge mine. I charged yours, but I forgot to charge mine. See, God damn it. That's what I get for being nice. Well, you can listen to music on yours. I'm fucking dumb. On the other note, I wonder if I got any fucking C4 chargers. Throw it on the back of that. Get some money. Oh, pretty. That's a Super B. 6.4 liter. God, today's so fucking nice out. Yo, it's fucking nice out. I'm out here in Amish. Want to smoke some doinks? I wonder whatever happened to that guy. He had his 5 minutes of fame and disappeared pretty good. I think coming up on the right here is like Lockheed's base. They make like all the fucking airplanes, like the F-16s and shit. They make like hella fast airplanes, and they're really expensive and they cost a lot of money. I know Lockheed's around here somewhere. It's fucking bananas, man. I just want to go there, just to go. Man, I'm burning up, so I know she gotta be hot. And I'm just in a fucking long sleeve. This is actually my grandfather's shirt. As you guys know, my grandfather passed away not too long ago. My poppy, he passed away, I think, like, almost immediately after my car wrecked, or immediately before it, I don't remember. So my grandfather passed away, and he had a fucking good run, man. I've talked about it before, I'm still pretty bummed about it, but he had a good run. He was in his 90s, man. Anybody who makes it to 90, as far as I'm concerned, has won. But yeah, so when my grandfather died, they take his shit out of the assisted living and whatnot, which he was suffering from a little bit of dementia towards the end of his days. He would still be able to hold a conversation and he would know who you were, but he had his good days and his bad days. Some days he was really good, some days he wasn't. But of course, towards the end of his life, there were more bad days than there were good days. Well, anyway, my mom asked if I wanted any of Poppy's stuff to remember him by. There was a cane that I got him a long time ago, a wooden cane I got him as a kid that I remember getting him at some sort of festival. I remember getting him this cane and my mom got it for me, and some other little just things to remember him by, and this is one of his shirts. And it's kind of like having my grandfather with me, one of the first person that taught me how to ride a motorcycle, actually, which is kind of weird. I feel like I'm kind of riding with him. Hopefully that's not too sentimental to some of you guys, but it means a lot to me, you know. Like, I miss my grandfather a lot. He taught me so much. He taught me how to weld. He taught me how to fucking ride motorcycles. He taught me a lot of stuff. He taught me how to shoot. My grandfather was there for a lot of the big stuff in my life, and he gave me some of my favorite hobbies. So before he got really, really sick, after my grandmother passed away, he ended up having a kidney infection. And during that time when he had the kidney infection, apparently for a lot of older people, it can really affect their mentality, where it almost acts the same way what happens when you have dementia. So they thought he had dementia, or like turned out that he just had a really nasty infection, and they couldn't get it under control. They didn't know what it was affecting his mental a lot, his mental psyche or whatever. He was like, so yeah, he got really sick with that kidney infection. Well, they couldn't get him under control. Dude was going fucking crazy. He had a cane. And he would start swatting at people, and at like fucking 89 years old, he's like hitting people with canes and shit because they think they're stealing from him. He thought people were robbing him, and they took him to jail. He was smashing windows with it. Dude, he's going. It's not funny because, like, that type of shit is very serious. I can't imagine being terrified of my own surroundings like that, not knowing what's going on. But it was funny afterwards because he knew that he was, like, when he sobered up, I'll call it, when they got the medicine in him and he sobered up, he was in jail. They arrested him. So my grandfather at, like, 89 years old was beating fucking windows and kicking some ass and absolutely just wrecking people. I can't hear shit on this thing. Did you say something about a bandana? Don't be this fucking guy, you piece of shit. If I had some C4 charges right now, I'd tell you what, I'd put you in a hurting. Fucking nice. Oh my god. I would drive the fuck out of that. Dude, I had this fucking weird urge for like wings and shit. I want some wings like a motherfucker. Yeah, we made it. Buddy, nice to meet you, bud. Yeah, it was. Where'd you ride from?
Dahlonega.
Yeah. How long of a fucking ride was that? Hold on, let me get this shit off.
Told me speak, but words are held accountable. Speaking starvation, feeling worthless cause my mouth is full. Work is insurmountable, curb me with the palpables, unexplained.